week. All right, here we go.
Welcome to the Four Guys with Quarters show, with your hosts Inferno, Assassin, and Clowns.
And hello, hello, welcome everyone to the Four Guys with Quarters podcast, episode 64 for October 22nd, 2015. It's almost Assassin's favorite time of the year, and you know what that is? The Halloween episode is coming next week, so get ready. Hopefully we can have a chef on the show as well, and maybe he'll get in costume for us, who knows. But if you're here for this week for the Halo conversation, it's going to probably be next week. We're going to have big Halo extravaganza next week, along with our most beautiful Halloween costumes. I'm going to be an Angry Bird. I'm going to be an Angry Bird again, I think.
You have to. It's like a trademark of the show, or no?
I know. I agree. I agree with you. Anyway, this week we have four wonderful human beings, gamers, average men, me included. I'm Inferno 217. Here almost every week, but for someone who's here every week, we turn to ZPCI Assassin, making his 64th straight appearance on the show. Welcome.
Hi.
Wow. We've got
little enthusiasm.
Yeah, right? We've got Little Turtle Boy.
Hi.
And we've got Italian Clowns.
What's up?
Also known by some as Caffone still, but either way. So yeah, this week, we only have a few topics. The big thing this week for people who are already here, people who are rolling in can still enter. We're going to do the drawing in the middle of the episode. We're giving away a full series Steam code, so PC version of Tales from the Borderlands from Telltale Games and, 2K. So if you guys haven't played this, you may have played it on the Xbox, maybe PS4, maybe wherever. I mean, it's on iOS, Android, it's on pretty much anything. Typical Telltale kind of game, you know, you make your choices, great storytelling, but in the world of Borderlands. So if you haven't checked it out, winning this code would probably be an awesome way to do that now that all five episodes have been released. And the fifth one got some really good reviews recently. I'm pretty sure I saw some 9.5s for the ending of the series, right? So some people saying maybe even Game of the Year worthy for a Telltale episode. I don't know about that, but
I'll have to play it to see.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I still have to play it too, but you could play it if you want to get in. Just type in !Tales. I'll put that in the chat as we're going here, but !Tales will get you in. So yeah, full Steam code giveaway for this just finished Telltale series. So yeah. Anyway, let's give a shout out to our sponsor before we get officially started. Yet again this week, I don't have a picture if you're watching the video podcast. I literally just got home like a half hour ago, so I didn't have any time to do it. But MoviePass.com, we're still appreciative of you, of course. And I personally am because I have the service and it's awesome. 93% of nationwide theaters in the U.S. you can go to and see one movie per day, every single day in a month for $30 a month if you would like. You can just go check into the theater, get your movie tickets with this credit card they give you, and it's an awesome service. Don't pay $12 a movie. Pay $30 a month and see as many movies as you want. So, yeah, MoviePass.com. Go to our site, 4GuysWithQuarters.com, for a two-week trial sign-up that will help out our site and the podcast and our streaming endeavors. So please go to our site and sign up for the two-week trial. And no obligation, 14 days. Go see 14 movies if you want and then cancel it. But try not to do that because the service is awesome. So definitely use that trial to check it out, see if it's for you. And if it's not for you, then it's not for you. But if it is, it's awesome, man. I see a movie like every week now. And yeah, $30 a month. MoviePass.com.
I would definitely have it like mainly towards the end of the year, like when all the good movies are coming out, like Star Wars.
Right, yeah. So towards the end of the year. I mean, just for Star Wars, I'm not sure if it's worth it. But there's going to be a ton of movies coming out that you're going to want to see. And when that new movie comes out, you can still use it. It's awesome. You can go on the day it comes out or even the day before and be like, hey, you know, I want to get my movie ticket for that new release. And no blockages like these AMC silver gift cards or any of that crap. Works on all movies. IMAX and 3D, you have to pay $10 more a month, but you can get one for IMAX and 3D movies as well. So, MoviePass.com. All right, so first topic, where are we going to go first? Let's get the quick stuff out first, shall we? Battlefield Hardline is getting a free DLC. I don't know if you guys heard about this, but yeah. Hardline is getting, it's just newly been added to the EA Access Vault. So if you haven't played that and you have the EA Access, you can play it for free now. But Hardline's getting a new DLC. It's called Blackout, and it's free. And so correct me if I'm wrong, but pretty much what it is they do add a few new weapons, not too many, but a couple new ones. A new version of the RO-933, which is my least favorite gun to go against, that damn thing. But all you assault players out there, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But it puts two of the maps that are already in the game at night. So it's not really new maps, but they're darker, so reimagining. Is that right, Turtle? That's right, isn't it?
I would say so.
Yeah, so what do you guys think? Is this enough to get us back on the Hardline, or is this kind of a little too late for EA? Hardline went to the vault mighty quick, did it not?
Well, I wouldn't say it's too late, since like if you're a premium pass holder, like there's still DLC packs coming out throughout the rest of the year.
Right. So, I mean, I feel like this is a play to be like, hey, look, like, we're giving free DLC, people. Let's, you know, come back to our game that has fewer people in it than Battlefield 4, which was a launch title.
One thing I did notice is I played both Hardline and Battlefield 4 on the same day and noticed that the servers for Battlefield 4 were unusually full compared to like the past times I played.
Right.
And I got into a few not so full servers on Hardline.
Yeah, exactly. Hardline, I think Hardline's dead to me. I don't know if I'm gonna want to go back. I mean, I did buy that first DLC pack. I'll probably go back, play a few rounds of that just to justify my $15, but or $10 or whatever the hell it was. 15, I think. But what do the other guys think? Assassin, what do you think about the new Hardline DLC?
It's nice, but I have no room on my hard drive, so it's not going to install at all.
Wow. Unbelievable.
I played the second DLC, the robbery DLC, the other day, and the maps were pretty good.
See, that's the thing that sucks, too, about Hardline. Like, it's going up against some pretty big multiplayer giants this fall, and granted the game is pretty much a year old, you know, it's hard to have that kind of staying power, but Battlefield 4 is still popular, like we've just said on the podcast, and Hardline is dying slow death, or quick death I should say. And you know, Battlefront's coming out, Halo 5, Black Ops 3, all games are expected to get pretty good review scores and that have had betas and people are hyped about, and I don't know.
Well, Battlefield 4, you know, is a good game, especially whenever it's been out for about 2 years. It was a launch title, and it's still being supported with new content.
Right, right.
And I think it's just like Hardline. A lot of people didn't see Hardline as a Battlefield title.
Right, right. A lot of
which
people,
which I kind of agree with. It should have just been like an all-new, like, series.
It could have been like Battlefield Vietnam. It could have been like you know, I don't know how much Vietnam was right at launch. I think it was like 20. But, I mean, I wouldn't say Hotline's only worth 20, but, I mean, it could have been like a, like an extra, quote-unquote, arcade title for those who've played Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3. Stuff like that, you know, not a full-fledged game, not a full-fledged 60, but, you know, something like that, and I think it would have its place. Or like Battlefield 1943. Has anybody on the... Have you guys played that?
Yeah.
Yep.
Is that the one that was like a cartoonish... Not Battlefield Heroes, but... It was kind of like a...
No, I don't think it was cartoonish. It wasn't cartoonish, Assassin, was it?
I might be thinking of Battlefield Heroes.
Yeah, no. Battlefield 1943 was like the standalone arcade title for 360. Yeah. So, I mean, it didn't have as many maps as Hardline, as many modes or whatever, but it was a divergence from the Battlefield series, and people still accepted it because it was only like an arcade title, you know? Like, somebody was like... who wants to play Battlefield and wants something new was okay dropping 20 on something that, you know, was just a little divergence because it was 20, not 60. So, yeah. Kappa Chimpy, a.k.a. Gorilla Bomb from back in the day, says in the chat, the C-hate drives are good, however they are. Are people asking about hard drives in the chat? Did I miss that? They're a cost like everything else. I'm not sure what he's talking about. Do you guys know what he's talking about?
Mm. No.
I missed it. Explain it again, Kappa Champion, in the chat, and we'll get back to you. So, do we have anything else to say about this? Battlefield Hardline, Blackout? I'm interested to check them out, but after that, am I going to play it? Probably not.
Yeah.
So sad. Right, Sassy?
Yep.
Wow.
You're so enthusiastic today.
I know. He really is.
Yep.
He really is.
I know what it is. He wants the show to hurry up and be over so we can go back to RockBand 4.
Oh, so Kappa Champion in the chat was saying it's Seagate because of what Sassin said about not having space on his hard drive. Right. Yeah, no. Assassin has had his trials and tribulations with hard drives in the past, so I think he knows about the external hard drive space, but that's a good recommendation. I also recommend Seagate hard drives for the Xbox, so good recommendation there. Sassy, you going to be getting a Seagate hard drive anytime soon, or what, big guy?
Probably at Black Friday, but if anyone buys this hard drive, don't buy it. It sucks.
Yeah, Toshiba hard drives, yeah.
You need a new hard drive, especially with all the games coming out this fall.
I know, they're all 50 gigs or up or higher, mm-hmm. or whatever.
Well, not Battlefront. Battlefront, I think, is supposed to be around like 19 or 20.
Right. Speaking of a game that has just recently come out that didn't really have too much of our interest because of past history of failures in the franchise, but now should probably have our interest... Assassin's Creed Syndicate's been getting awesome reviews, people. I don't know if you haven't gotten the memo, but there is a new Assassin's Creed game. It did come out before November. It kind of slid under the rug a little bit. This one kind of snuck up on me, to be honest with you.
I think it releases tomorrow.
Well, tomorrow, rather, yeah. So, on the 23rd. So, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, the reviews are coming in, and... Big outlets are giving it big scores, guys. Above 80s from pretty much everyone. Scores in the 90s from, you know, Game Informer, GameSpot, you know, saying that the series is getting back to its roots. You know, I can't remember if it was Polygon or Game Informer specifically that said that the series is kind of getting away from adding fluff and adding stuff that didn't work and just got to back to... what did work and what made Assassin's Creed a huge, a huge game.
Like, for example, with Syndicate, I don't think it has any kind of multiplayer aspects.
Right.
It's just all single player, which is what the series is known for.
Right. And I like, they've made some changes, but it feels like it's appropriate for what the series is going for or what the series originated on. So, like, for instance, now, like, for assassination attempts, you can use, like, items in the arena, not the arena, in the atmosphere, like the, environment, I should say. I couldn't think of that word. Items in the environment. You can, like, drop things on people from buildings and stuff like that. You know, that makes perfect sense because you're an assassin. Like, that makes total sense. But, like, some of the crap they've added in the past games is just, ugh, yuck.
And all the issues with frame rate and stuttering and glitches that Unity had, like, I think was traced back to the multiplayer.
Yeah.
Like, online connected, like, staying online connected the whole time was, mm-hmm. like, impacting the frame rate and mm-hmm. everything. Mm-hmm. So without that, maybe it's finally a smooth experience. I've watched a few gameplay videos, and it actually did look like it was running smooth.
Right. Yeah, no, that's what the reviews have been saying. Like, you know, this is, they said, is it perfect? Is it glitch-free? No, but I mean, what Ubisoft is glitch game is glitch-free. But is it much of a mess as Unity? Absolutely not. Mm. Absolutely not. So it's a good point you bring up, Turtle. It runs smoother. It runs a lot smoother, according to pretty much everybody.
I'll probably pick it up whenever the price drops to around like 30 or 40.
Which will probably be Black Friday. I'm expecting to pick this up on Black Friday. Let me just get that out there. I think Black Friday, I'll be able to find this for 40, you know, at most like 45. And but then again, I said the same thing about Evil Within last year. I was like, okay, if Evil Within's 40, I'm getting it. And then Black Friday ads come out and it was like 17. I'm like, yeah, I'm sold. Like, you know, so I don't you know, believe me when it comes to prices. But I think that this one is not going to go much lower than 40. But if it's 17, I'll take it. I'll take it for 17. What do the other guys think about Syndicate? Have you guys seen anything or encouraged by the new by the reviews? It's going back to its roots, Assassin or Clowns or.
Unity put a bad taste in my mouth. You know,
yeah, but this is better.
Awful.
This is.
I know, it was awful. And knowing that Syndicate's better, I might. You know, before, you know, last week, 0% chance of buying it.
Right, right.
Knowing what they said today, maybe a 50% chance.
Like, Polygon says, like, since Brotherhood, I guess. You know, I don't agree with that either, because what I'm about to say, because I think Assassin's Creed 4 was very good. I mean, I didn't get through the whole thing, but I thought Black Flag was excellent. But yeah. Polygon says this is the first game since Brotherhood that's taken steps uniformly in a positive direction. Like, nothing that they took, the steps they took were not, nothing was really negative. Everything was positive, but still there's more to do. There's more to work on to return it back to form. So, I mean, what do you guys think? I mean, Black Flag was excellent. That's why I think that's why Unity was such a letdown. If Black Flag was bad and then Unity was bad, people wouldn't say, "Oh, Unity sucked." You know what I mean?
I'm still playing Black Flag.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I haven't beaten it, but like the world, like if you've played it and like zoomed out on the map, you know how big that game world is. Like, mm-hmm. there's a lot to do and explore, mm-hmm. especially if you're like me and have to explore like every little space.
Right. Right.
But like, Black Flag, I think, was underrated.
Mm-hmm. I agree. And I think Unity was just so bad that people are just like, oh, Assassin's Creed's been bad. Like, Assassin's Creed's just been terrible, and this game had to be good or else Assassin's Creed was dead. But keep in mind, 2 years ago, Black Flag came out, and it was excellent.
It's more like Unity kind of like ruined the series.
Right.
Like, from how people reacted to it. Like, you know, like you said, like, people were, like, hating Black Flag for, like, no reason. Mm-hmm. And, like, saying that 3 was bad, and I actually thought 3 was alright.
See, I played a little bit of 3. I mean, I didn't finish it, because I wasn't too into the series, really. But, I mean, it was alright. It was okay.
3 had a very, very slow start, but once you got started, like, 2 hours in, it started to pick up and, like, got good.
Right, right.
But, like, with all the problems Unity had, I think it just kind of ruined the series for a lot of people.
Right. Assassin included, right?
Yep.
J Street in the chat says, new Assassin's Creed game, you kidding? I take it that as sarcasm, but I'm not going to lie to you, J Street. This kind of snuck up on me. I knew it was coming, but if, you know, if I didn't see any reviews or I didn't hear these guys talking about it, I would have totally forgotten about it. It's not like Black Ops where it's like every year, or Call of Duty, every year you know it's coming out like first, second week in November. You know to expect it. You know it's coming. You're going to see it. I haven't even seen like many ads like in the stores or on TV or anything. This kind of snuck up on me here.
I think their advertising is mainly online, because I get ads before YouTube videos all the time, at least probably several times a day.
Mm-hmm.
And like little ads over in the corners of web pages.
Yep. Yep.
So I think Ubisoft knows where their audience is, and it's not on TV.
Yeah, not anymore, at least. What was the Assassin's Creed game that was... It was a Black Flag of Unity. It was one of the ones in this generation that had a lot of TV ads.
I think it was Unity.
Yeah.
Because Unity was supposed to be, like, the big game.
Unity was supposed to be the one that was perfect single player and multiplayer, and we got guys with invisible faces and eyeballs floating, so... Unbelievable. Yeah, anything else about Syndicate? It comes out tomorrow. I don't know if it comes off of PC, I'm not gonna lie, but it definitely comes off for Xbox One and PS4.
I think it's all systems.
Okay.
I can double check on that.
Anything else about Syndicate from anyone?
Why does it come out on Friday? Like,
yeah,
what's with like a few games coming out on Friday?
What is with that? That's a good discussion.
Okay, I think I know the answer to this. Over the summer, I don't know if you know about this, but like over the summer, they switched music releases to Fridays because they're trying to make Fridays like the universal release date for like all countries.
Interesting.
So like if something comes out on Friday, it comes out on Friday everywhere. At the same time.
Interesting.
Where'd you hear that from?
It was like a big thing like back in like the spring or whatever. Like they said that they were moving music sales for like CDs and new albums and everything to Fridays. So I think they're trying to do the same with games and movies. Like movies come out in theaters on Fridays already.
Right.
So I think they're trying to make Fridays like a universal thing for like starting over with like launch week sales and stuff, like make tracking easier.
I don't think I've bought a CD since Tub Thumper, like Chumbawamba. I think that was like the last CD I ever bought.
To be honest. Is that like Bop?
Same time period. Yeah. You know, same time period.
You know that song is you know that song's DLC on Rock Band, right?
No, I did not know that. Oh, no, I did know that because I do own it. Yes. I got to do another stream of some DLC now that I have more of it downloaded. I've got to do another Rock Band 4 DLC stream. JStream makes a good point in the chat. He says, why not do Friday when most people get paid? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's true, too. I mean, you get paid on the prior Friday. A lot of people know this. Your money may be gone by that Tuesday. You might not be able to buy that game, but if you get paid on that Friday, you're at GameStop by 5:30. If 5 o'clock comes, you're out there, you're at GameStop at 5:30. That's an interesting point, Jay Street. I like that.
What day does Assassin get paid?
Assassin, what day do you get paid?
Every day.
I knew that was coming. I get paid on Thursdays, usually. Every other Thursday, I think. Something like that. So, yeah, anything else about Syndicate before we get off this?
Oh, here it is. Microsoft Windows PC, November 19th. So it's not coming out tomorrow for PC.
Okay, PC, you're going to have to wait a little bit. But that's probably good. Weather the storm, see how people are doing, what the games are doing on the other consoles, get more people's reviews, get the small guys' reviews.
Let the console peasants work out the bugs find them before right. The PC master race.
Exactly. All right. Another just quick announcement kind of thing. The Doom closed alpha. You thought this would never come, people. You bought that Wolfenstein Old Blood year and 8 months ago, whenever the hell that was.
It was like May of last year.
May of 2014, and you got a little pamphlet in there that said, register for Doom closed alpha access. And
if you registered, go check your email because you most likely have a code right now.
That's right.
Hold on, wait. What do you think clowns did with that notification?
Did you delete it?
I had no interest in the beta.
No way! We could have given away the code.
I didn't even get one.
And I didn't get
code for the fucking beta.
I didn't get one. I haven't checked, though, very thoroughly. I probably do have one. But yeah, anyway, the dates are this weekend only, which is kind of a bummer, man. I'm not going to lie. You wait a year and 8 months, and the beta is only this weekend, the 23rd or the 25th. So 3 full days of beta, or alpha, rather. I keep saying beta. I'm so used to saying beta this, beta that. Closed alpha. It's 6v6 multiplayer. That's essentially all I know. I don't know the guns that are in it, but there is a list on the website.
I think there's only like one gun that like everyone has.
There's a bunch of like super weapon pickups on the map though. I was reading about. So I don't have the exact details right in front of me. And quite honestly, I'm probably not even gonna play the alpha. Even if I do have a code, if I have a code, I'm gonna give it away on Twitter. So look to Twitter for it. Not that I'm not interested, but I mean, I'm gonna be playing Halo in preparation Halo 5. And I'll get in on the beta for Doom. The alphas don't really excite me, other than Halo 5 Alpha. But Turtle will be playing it.
Yeah.
Right?
Seems like I'll be the only one with an opinion next week.
Nope. I hate to say it, I got a pun for this. Doomed to fail.
Wow, Schlounce. Oh, God. I have a feeling you're probably right.
I just think it's the wrong time to throw this out there. And I think Bethesda's doing it kind of like as a filler thing. Because, I mean, like, they got Fallout 4 coming with DLC. They got Halo 5. So you got, like, Halo 5, Fallout 4, like, right next to each other. I mean, think about it.
Yeah. Oh, go ahead, Assassin.
Bethesda wants to put out more games. They even put out a statement that they don't want to release a game every so many years, you can tell.
But my concern would be, are they going to rush, or are they going to lose quality, or are they going to expand their studio? Because, I mean, like, when they make games, though, like Skyrim and Fallout, they put a lot of effort and time into the storyline, the dialogue, the choices. So, I mean,
and then they release something like The Evil Within that's just not that great.
I thought, was that them that did Evil Within?
Yeah,
it was. Sadly enough. I don't know. How long has it been since the last Doom? It's been a while, right? I mean, was there a Doom on the 360?
Yeah, I think they released like a remaster or something.
Oh, yeah, they did. Yep, you're right. They released a remaster.
There was that awesome movie that came out.
I'm unfamiliar with the movie. God. Assassin.
Oh, The Rock. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Wait, The Rock was in a Doom movie? Did I?
Yeah.
No way.
It was awful.
What rock have you been under for the last like decade or Dude. However long it's been out?
Man, I've only had Movie Pass for probably 6 months. So I wasn't seeing movies before that. No, but in all seriousness, I had no idea that there was a Doom movie with The Rock.
Don't watch it. Don't watch it.
Oh, man.
Came out 2005, so 10 years ago.
Gotcha. Okay. All right. I feel bad because this series was like so near and dear to my heart as a kid, and I'm sure Clowns too. Like, this was the FPS. Like, this is what everyone played. This was on like every console imaginable. This was on like SNES, Atari Jaguar. I don't know if it was on Genesis, to be honest with you, but it was on pretty much everything, man. It was on PC.
I remember the Jaguar version. I liked it. And I liked the PC version back in the day and all the little hacks that they had for it. I don't know if you remember that.
I do, yeah.
You could, like, walk in the mall, and there would be, like, those little guys at the kiosk or carts, whatever you call them back in the day, that sell, like, modified floppy disks of, like, Doom hacks. It's really crazy. I used to buy a ton of that.
Yeah, yeah. So it's sad for us old guys, quote-unquote, to see this franchise kind of nosediving. But hopefully this game picks it up. But as Clowns has said with his pun,
Too optimistic. The gameplay that we saw at E3 looked good.
It looked good, but
so did Unity. Bethesda
has great graphics for their time period, but that's all the game might have. I mean, like, corridor games? How much longer can they keep making those kind of games?
Yeah.
Think about it.
Yeah.
I mean, what was the biggest complaint with that? What was that last Aliens Isolation game? Everyone's like, oh, another quarter type game.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Epic. No.
Yeah, it's like Wolfenstein, okay? Wolfenstein's a quarter type game, and that game was like how many hours, Assassin, like for the single player, the original?
It's
going to be like 20, right? At least. Like maybe like 16 to 20 hours to complete Wolfenstein the Old Blood. So if Doom is like anything less than 12 hours, I think it's destined to fail. I don't think anyone's going to play the multiplayer that much. I just, even though the multiplayer looks cool and they're going to have this closed beta alpha for the multiplayer, I just don't think people are playing it, guys. I just don't think they're playing it.
Well, I just want to go ahead and say I've never played Doom, like any version.
Okay, after this podcast, you need to do something about that. Like Doom, if you were to download a copy of, Doom may be like freeware at this point. It's so old and popular. We need to get you a copy of Doom. Like you need to at least play it.
I never played Doom either.
Okay, you people are so young and unbelievable. You know, these people.
The closest game I can compare it to, at least right now, besides Alien Isolation, the most epic game that's ever come out, would be Tower of Guns. Was very similar to the style.
Yes.
Of like the way you walked.
Yeah. Very good. Very good comparison.
I agree. I may like it then.
Yeah, it's not quite as off the wall as Tower of Guns, yeah. Or the levels aren't like procedurally generated either, you know what I mean? It's set on rails. It's a same experience every time, but yeah, that's definitely where Tower of Guns got their inspiration. Good reference, Clowns. That was excellent.
Assassin, we can get Doom 3 BFG edition on Steam for $20.
$20? No.
Yep.
And we're not talking about Doom 3, by the way. We're talking about the original. You got to play the original Doom.
I know.
Not Doom 3.
I'm trying to find out if it's on Steam.
All right, anyway, so that's the Doom Alpha. Xbox One, PS4, PC, this weekend only. So if you have a code, input it and get on there and hopefully give some feedback. They probably get no feedback on it, to be honest with you. I would love to see the kind of feedback they get on it. What next? There's only like a couple more topics. We're going to give away our Tales of the Borderlands code in just a little bit. So if you haven't gotten in and you want to, exclamation point Tales. I'll put another ad thing in the chat from the bot. Exclamation point Tales to get your Steam code for the entire series of Tales from the Borderlands. And if you retweeted or followed on Twitter earlier today, thank you very much for doing so. We appreciate that. Assassin did good job advertising, and we got some retweets and stuff, but we gotta get more entries right now, guys. Get some more entries. You know you people want this. It's a great game. Like, people don't look at games like this, like adaptations of other games, and say, oh, it's as good as the original. Like, people wouldn't say Tales from the Borderlands is as good as the original, and they haven't played it. If you say that, you haven't played it. Like, it's good. Same thing with the Minecraft. We were talking about last week. People were like, oh, Minecraft story mode. It's not going to be as good as the original. It's never going to be as good as Minecraft. Come on, that's not what Minecraft's about. And then Telltale gives us something awesome. You know?
Yeah, I do have to say that Tales from the Borderlands and the Borderlands game series are like two completely different types of games.
Right.
Like, you can't judge one based on the other.
Right. So give it a try, people. Enter exclamation point Tails. Like Sonic and Tails.
I have to say, I mean, I just played through episode 4 and 5 of Tales from the Borderlands, and I love it, dude. Episode 4 was really good. Mm. Episode 5, I didn't think was as great as the reviews are out there hyping up, like contender for Game of the Year. But, I mean, it's still epic. Don't get me wrong. I think, you know, Fallout's going to be, like, Game of the Year.
Mm-hmm.
But, however, it is a really good finish, and people are believing now that it may lead up to clues to Borderlands 3.
Mm-hmm.
That some of what happens in this relates to Borderlands 3.
That'd be awesome, man. That'd be awesome. And I like a game like this that isn't you know, on the same track as, or isn't in, like, it's not another Borderlands, it's not simply another Borderlands game, it's made by Telltale, like we've been talking about. But I like how a game like this is able to build up hype for an upcoming game in the original series. I like that. I like that another company can help build hype for another game, another company's game, you know?
It's awesome, man.
What were you going to say, Turtle?
Oh, I just want to get back to the Doom thing. The original is on Steam for
$4.99.
Just thought I'd throw that out there. It's the original.
You'd be able to run that on your computer at probably like 1,200 frames a second. That's how non-demanding it is. It's probably on phones. Like, I'm gonna look in and see if it's on the Android market, because probably is. I mean, it's not demanding at all. People were running this on like their TI-84 calculators in high school and stuff like that. That's probably an exaggeration, but I mean, yeah. It's not too demanding, and it's an awesome game. People should try it.
No, I think you're actually correct. I think somebody did port the TI-84. I think you are right.
That's funny. All right, from one first-person shooter to the next, before we give away our code, Call of Duty, ladies and gentlemen, on the Xbox 360 and PS4 is going to run in 30 frames a second, guys. Or PS3, rather. Xbox 3, thank you. Xbox 360 and PS3 is going to run at 30 FPS. Isn't that disgusting?
Not really.
What?
Why? See, the problem is, why would you make such a graphically induced and resource-heavy game and then throw it on last gen and say, hey, it's going to run at 30 frames per second? Because, you know, when it gets heavy to, like, the battle, it's going to lag at, like, 20 frames per second.
No, I don't think it will.
This is the thing, okay? They said they had it running at 60 FPS, but what clowns just said happened. That's why they made the decision they're going to put it at 30, because they're not going to put it at, like, 45. You know, people don't do that. It's either 60 or 30, generally. So, like, what clowns are saying is true in that, you know, every other game in the series has been at 60, but this game has just got so much going for it that they have to put it at 30 now.
No, I thought the other games for last gen were 30 frames, because I played Black Ops 2 like a week or two ago, and it was not 60.
Assassin?
I don't know.
No, it is. Black Ops 2 is at 30. I mean 60.
Maybe on PC, but I played it and it felt a lot slower. Like the frame rate, you know how like whenever you play a 30 frame game and then a 60 frame game, like you can tell the difference just by how the game looks. Like when you're walking or something, like that's what I'm talking about. Like I played Black Ops 2 and it looks slower. I don't know if that makes sense.
Okay, initial look indicates that... Sorry, that was really loud. I was too close to my phone. Initially, the first look says all COD games were in 60 FPS on Xbox, but the later ones dropped into the 40s. So, like, Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 3 dropped into the 40s sometimes, but everything before that was in 60.
Oh, well, see, I came into the series at, like, Modern Warfare 2 and 3.
Kappa, yeah, true, okay. So, yeah, that makes sense. Kappa Chimpy says, that sounds terrible, but you have to remember old-gen Battlefield 4 and Destiny are both 30 FPS. New-gen Destiny is at 30 FPS.
Mm-hmm.
But do you...
I have Battlefield 4 on both the PS3 and the PS4, and yes, that is a huge difference.
Yeah, I think it's a huge difference. Either way, like, I think between 30 and 60 in such a twitch shooting game like Call of Duty, and we'll let our resident Call of Dudite on the panel get his opinion in a second. I think the difference between 30 and 60 is massive on FPS games. I'm sorry. When Battlefield 4 went to 60 FPS in the Xbox One, it's the first thing I noticed. It's the first thing I noticed coming from Battlefield on the 360. I played the hell out of Battlefield 3 on the 360, and at 30 FPS, it felt fine. I got along. I didn't know better. I wasn't a PC gamer. I didn't play Call of Duty anymore. I didn't know better. But then when it went to 60, I was like, damn, like this is how shooting should be. And having such a huge franchise that the... what do you want to call him? What do you want to call David Vondahar, or whatever his name is? Assassin.
douchebag.
Okay, well, I'm not going to say
we can't.
I'm not going to say that, but Vondahar said himself in 2012 that if it's not 60 FPS, it's not Call of Duty. You can look that up. You can look that up. And now they're going to release a 30 FPS Call of Duty on PS4. I mean, on PS3 and Xbox 360. That's disgusting.
Well, three words. Activision and money. That's all they want.
I mean, they're releasing it without the campaign. They're releasing it at 30 FPS. I would love to see the sales numbers. You know what? It's like what I say about Apple. Like some people with Apple, they buy everything Apple. They buy Apple Watch, they buy Apple computers, they buy Apple phones, they buy Apple toilets, whatever. They're eye sheep. They're people that are Call of Duty sheep. Okay, they'll buy whatever they pump out, and people are gonna buy this at 30 FPS, and they're gonna complain, but they're still gonna spend their money. So,
hold on, wait, I got a question. Assassin, are we buying Black Ops 3?
On the Xbox One, not last gen.
Okay, so
absolutely not.
So, like, when you looked at the older games, right? You looked at like Ghosts or even Advanced Warfare. Like, what was the difference other than frame rate and graphics on the two? Nothing, right, Assassin?
Nothing really. Right. Major.
It was 60 FPS. Did it still look like? Did it look like poo compared to the next gen versions? Yes. There was no difference. Like, if you had the old systems, you still got, you know, the Call of Duty experience you expect every single year, debatably. You know, Ghost sucked. Advanced Warfare, not that great, but still better. And so I think this is a big, big misstep, and this definitely... I didn't think that this was going to come to old gen at all. I didn't think Black Ops 3 would come to old gen at all. But now that they're putting this one at 30 FPS, I think this is it for the old gen ones.
Especially since so many games like were originally announced for both last gen and this gen, and then had last gen canceled. Like, I really thought that Call of Duty was finally moving on.
I thought so too. And especially since they had to cut out the campaign. Like, no one plays the campaign really in Call of Duty except a resident panel Call of Duty ZBCI assassin. But
I've never finished a Call of Duty campaign, never.
I think the last one I finished was the original Modern Warfare. But that said, like, taking something out of a game is noteworthy, even though no one plays it. Like, if you know that it's there on a different system and you have the 360 and the Xbox One version is going to have, or the PS4 version is going to have the campaign, like, that sucks.
How much is it going to be on last gen? 40 or 50?
Assassin?
50.
See, it should be at least 30.
Yeah,
so you're only getting half a game.
You're getting half the game. You're getting half the frame rate. It should be 15. No, I'm being ridiculous. That is a lie. But it should not be 50. I'm sorry. Should not be $50.
Kind of like a Pro Skater 5, which is also at Division.
How much is that on LGen?
50. But it also got delayed until next year for last gen.
Ew. That's going the way of the Mortal Kombat X, I guarantee it. Probably won't even get released. That won't even get released. I'm trying to find the comment of David Vondahar. I paraphrased. That's not exactly what he said, but he essentially said that 60 FPS is like vital to Call of Duty experience, and yet they're releasing one with the 30. It's awful.
I kind of think Call of Duty fell off the wagon. I mean, it's losing its like MLG kind of prestige there. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not as big as it used to be. After Ghost came out and Advanced Warfare, it just seems like the people care less about the MLG competitions than they did when it was like Black Ops 2 or Modern Warfare 3.
Mm-hmm. I honestly think that all the MLG people are going to be switching to Halo 5.
Yep.
Especially since it has dedicated esports features.
I hate to say it, but on this I will have to disagree, only because PS4 and MLG signed an exclusive agreement that PS4 is the official system of MLG now.
So then,
those are the
Okay, so then on PS4, what's going to be the game?
I'm not sure, but they're not going to be running Xbox Ones and MLG competitions.
Because that sucks.
Of that Sony agreement.
So what's going to happen to the Halo Championship Series?
It'll probably have to be, there's that other esports league. I forget what they refer to themselves as. I think like GSL or something.
Yeah.
I think it's probably going to have to go to that.
Well, Halo is... I think Halo is doing really well on the hype train, and I think a lot of people are going to be looking to watch those competitions and stuff, so I think it's a bad move if they're going to just, like, throw that out the window. But I think you're right about the PS4 thing. I think I did hear that about... And the Black Ops moved... Black Ops exclusive 2-week early exclusive access to the DLC, or month early, or whatever it is. Month early, right? Move to PS4 as well, so I think you're right, Clowns. I think that they're moving over to PS4 and they're going to miss out on Halo.
And the sad thing is, though, I mean, people are going to be more interested in Halo multiplayer right now than they are in Call of Duty, because Call of Duty's wore itself out.
Right. Yep.
And when was the last time, besides Master Chief Collection, when's the last time you had a near multiplayer Halo game?
Yeah, Halo 4, which people didn't like because it went the way of Call of Duty. Like,
I'm just talking about release dates. Like, you have Call of Duty, like, less than a year apart.
Right, exactly.
Every year.
Right. The Jizzle in the chat says, breaking news, Black Ops 3 to be $20 at Black Friday on Walmart. Now, I rarely do this on the podcast, but link please are fake. Picture it didn't happen. One of the two. Provide some source. Evidence of that, please.
Provide your source.
And we'll get back to this. We'll get back to this. All right, so yeah, that's Black Ops only at 30 FPS. Great. Good job. Thank you. Oh, he's trolling. Okay. I figured. All right,
bad
so
jizzle.
Yeah, very bad. Very bad jizzle. I can't take away quarters from you, but if I could, you'd get that trolling subtraction of quarters from our system. Speaking of which, we're going to do our giveaway right now. We're going to draw our, close it, entry closed, and we're going to draw our winner for the Tales from the Borderlands Steam code giveaway, sponsored, by Telltale. Pick? Did it go on the chat? It did.
Yep.
So, Kappa Chibi, congratulations. You've won a code for Steam, so a PC version, for Tales from the Borderlands. So, congratulations. I will send you that on Twitch through a Twitch message after the show.
So, and once you play it, Kappa, let Inferno know what you think of it.
Yeah. Opinion. Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, after you play it, tweet at us and let us know what you think of Tales of the Borderlands. We'd love to hear what you guys think about it. Anybody, even if you guys have it and you didn't win the code, definitely let us know what you think of the series, of the Telltale series, because overall we're pretty big fans. So yeah. So the last thing I have for the episode that I prepared is kind of controversial, but I figured we get into it for, like, you know, maximum of 10 minutes. Just to close out the show, we have Rock Band and Guitar Hero released now. We all have Rock Band 4, and Turtle has Guitar Hero Live, and I've played Guitar Hero Live at the store for about 30 minutes. And now that they're both out, we want to get some more input on what we think of Rock Band 4 and maybe a little versus thing, what's better on which one, and chat about that real quick.
Just a little side note, I like that you used the Wii U box art for Guitar Hero.
Thank you. I was wondering if anyone would notice that. Because I think it's ridiculous that it got a Wii U release. Like,
yeah, got an iOS release, too.
How do you play on the iOS? You just tap? Same.
No, there's a special edition, like, you actually use the guitar with your iOS device.
Can you imagine? This is something Clowns could be able to do, though, with a 6 Plus.
The question is, How much is that guitar just to play with iOS? Is it going to be ridiculous?
It's its own edition. Like, they released it as a platform alongside Xbox.
No PlayStation way. Either. So you're telling me there's a boxed version of the iOS version?
Yeah.
No.
It doesn't come with the device, but it comes with the...
dollars for the iOS version?
What is it?
How much do I have to pay for the iOS version?
I don't know how much it is. I yeah. looked that up.
Because here's the benefit. The 6 Plus' Bluetooth, I think, is similar to PS4's Bluetooth. And I wonder if the guitar's Bluetooth, if I could...
$99. Dude,
it is. It's $100.
It's the same iOS as the console.
Well... Steve Jobs just lost a customer.
Steve Jobs in his grave has just lost an iOS customer. But yeah, $100, get out of here, man. That's ridiculous.
It comes with its own guitar.
I might as well pay $100 for the Wii U version.
Right.
Or has a little bit of resale value.
Or for the Xbox version.
$10.
Yeah, no, I agree.
One thing I did notice, I have not tried this yet, but... on the Xbox One version, on the main menu, if you press one of the buttons, it brings up an app link code. So I don't know what that's used for, but I'm going to look it up after the show.
Yeah, you need to let us know. Do that and let us know. Because that would be, I'm interested to find out what that does.
I don't know if there's like a companion app or not, or if this is like a to link, like a verification for the iOS version.
Right.
I don't know what it's for.
Right.
It doesn't say whenever you do whenever you click on it in the game, it just says it just gives you a code and just tells you to enter it on your device or whatever.
Right.
It doesn't say specifically.
Interesting.
Couldn't you use your phone as a microphone for the game?
Can you imagine this? Can you just imagine this? Now you won't get the full effect, people, unless you're watching the video version. Clouds is sitting there with his daughter and, you know, whoever, his daughter's boyfriend or whatever, and he's got the phone like this, right? I'll get my phone out. He's singing, right? Or his daughter's singing, and they've got the two guitar bundle for the $150 Guitar Hero Live, and Clouds' daughter is like, singing into the microphone of the phone like this, right? And they're trying to watch the notes on the 6 Plus going along like this.
I know. It'd be pretty bad. You might as well just get the, whatchamacallit, the iPad and just do it on the iPad.
Get the iPad! Oh, I don't have my tablet here, but if you got the iPad, you just hold
it. Well, I think it is on. It's iOS, so it does work on the tablets.
Right, so you get your iPad. You hold your iPad up. Oh my god!
Wait, is there an Android version coming out anytime soon?
Oh, that I don't know. Probably not.
Because Assassin could have done that one. We could have given that one to Assassin.
Oh my god, they are so money hungry. They're money hungry. This is typical Activision, though. Jesus. Anyway, so yeah, Guitar Hero Live versus Rock Band 4. Before we get into the versus turtle, let's ask Assassin, because he did get his copy, and he's been playing it now with his very own repurposed secondhand guitar. Go ahead, Assassin, tell us what you think of Rock Band 4.
If it wasn't missing some features like multiplayer, it would be a great Rock Band game for everyone.
Yeah, I mean, like we've talked about in the past, I think the track list has got a little bit of everything for everyone. I mean, it's not great. It's not everything that... It's not like you know every song on there, but there are a great variety of genres and all that DLC and... Yeah, but no multiplayer. Is there multiplayer in Guitar Hero Live?
Yes, but to some extent for now. And I can't explain that.
Wait, what? Say that again?
Like, there's, like, to some extent right now, there is multiplayer in, like, online multiplayer in
Guitar Hero. Is it, like, leaderboard score attack, kind of?
Okay, let me just explain this, because it's kind of confusing. On Guitar Hero, whenever you go to GHTV, which is the online component, whenever you're playing a song on there, you have, like, a top 10 leaderboard, but... there's like a little white mark on the names to indicate if they're online or not, like if they're actively playing or not. So you could be playing against just like a top 10 leaderboard, or there could be someone actually playing at the same time you're playing.
Gotcha.
So that's as far as the multiplayer goes for now. But just like RockBand 4, there's, I think, with RockBand 4, like, there's plans to release it in a patch for, like, online head-to-head.
Right, right.
Like, they have said that for Guitar Hero, that is coming.
Yeah, man, that online head-to-head is where it's at. Like, especially for us, like, we're at different parts of the country. I mean, it's awesome. The local multiplayer is awesome. You know, having the band in Rock Band 4, I think, is a huge advantage with the drums and the singing and having everyone do their own thing and put all of the music together. I do like that, but man, I want to play with you guys in Rock Band 4, you know, and I want to, I've met people online. I want to do, you know, even if it's quick play, like everyone getting together and play a separate part of quick play, I want to do that.
You know, maybe when the Nintendo NX console comes out, they'll add something like that. Imagine, like, Assassin, like, traveling somewhere with his mom, sitting at the store waiting, and he just breaks out the NX console, puts it on his phone's Wi-Fi, jams on the guitar in the middle of the grocery store or something. I mean, it's possible.
Right.
For next gen.
Assassin pulls out his little NX. This is going to be his NX right here. He pulls it out. He's like, you know, it's floating in the air. The drums floating in the air. He has his drumsticks, and he's going...
They lower the lights at the store, and the bag was like, you go, you rock, man!
Everyone just comes out of the aisles, and they're just like, carry on my way! You know, yeah, like the background
vocals. You got the, like, in the produce area, you got, like, the mist sprayers, like, creating kind of like a fog effect.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
They bring it to us. Bring cheese at them.
Yep, yep. Bring it to us, Nintendo. Bring us that good stuff next year. Come on, now. But yeah, Rock Band 4 vs. Guitar Hero Live. Maybe we'll do this like checklist style. So how about tracks, like music on disc? Because we know DLC, it's Rock Band 4. But music on disc, Guitar Hero or Rock Band, Turtle?
I'd say Guitar Hero for on disc.
I gotta be honest with you, I would say Guitar Hero as well. I think it's high.
There's been a few songs on Rock Band that I've been like never would have heard of before, and just like, yeah, that's a great song, like. I like it. But as far as songs that I know, there's more that I know on Guitar Hero.
Exactly. Exactly.
But how much is the DLC songs on Guitar Hero versus Rock Band?
Free.
No. Eternal. Please. Okay. Guitar Hero TV is not DLC.
No, it's not.
All right. Then why'd you say free?
Because you can play all the songs without paying anything.
Oh, okay. All right. That's fair. But that's not exactly what we're talking about.
If I was to be a paying customer.
Yes. If you didn't earn the XP to play those Guitar Hero Live songs, potentially how much would you have to pay? I don't know the pricing structure either. I thought it was like $5.99 for like,
I think, 10 songs. I think you can get like three plays or whatever they're called in the game. I think you can get them for like, I actually have the store page up right here. I can tell you the DLC. The lowest is 99 cents.
So 99 cents gets you three plays.
Can I play it permanently, like all the time, whenever I want to play it, like Rock Band?
No, you get a play. You get plays, and like each time you play, uses one play.
You can't buy a permanent play on it.
No, but they do have this GHTV Party Pass. Like if you throw a party or something, and it's like $5 or whatever, and it permanently gives you unlimited access to all the songs for like 24 hours.
Wow, talk about greedy, huh? Rock Band. Me and Assassin, we could buy like packs of songs. I just bought. What did I buy, Assassin? That lag? What was it? Nickelback, right?
Yeah, the Nickelback pack.
Yeah, and we could play it as many times as we want. Assassin could jam out, and my daughter could sing it. But with Guitar Hero, I can only play it three times? What a ripoff!
Man, you can play it unlimited times as long as you have the plays, which are very easy to earn.
So you got to earn play. This is It's an interesting structure. I don't agree with it either. Because not everyone's going to get enough XP to play it as many times as they want. I just don't think
you get a lot. When like, you get XP fast. Like, every
I
other.
I have to correct you on this, Turtle, though, because you say you get enough XP, you can play it whenever you want. So if I get enough XP and I buy it for 3 plays, I can play it whenever I want? Or do I got to keep earning XP to keep rebuying it to play it when I want?
Well, there's a level cap. There. It only goes to 20.
Whoa, what? So once you hit level 20, you don't earn any more XP towards buying the songs?
Yeah, you... All right. Here's another way that it works. You can use in-game currency, which you keep earning after you hit level cap.
Okay.
And that's easy to earn. You, like, I think to get, like, 3 plays is, like, 1,800 credit, and you get, like, over... Like, I've been getting constantly, like, over 100, like, around, like, 150... coins or whatever per song that I play.
Mm-hmm.
So like, if you play a lot, then it like adds up.
What if you play on easy?
Yeah, you like. I think how much you get depends on like how good you're doing the song. So like, if you're playing on easy and like you're hitting all the notes, you probably won't get a lot. I haven't tested it, but I can.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. Interesting. Go ahead.
But realistically, there is no paywall.
Right, I mean, you can earn the XP to buy to get the plays. So realistically, yeah, there isn't a pay wall, but there is a pay.
There's like a pay steps. Like pay to play now.
Right,
kind of thing. But like, honestly, like all the controversy about it is just like not accurate.
So
because the game just came out.
Here's the problem: if I earn XP one time to buy it one time, I want it forever. I don't want to have to keep earning XP and then keep earning XP and play it again or in-game currency. With Rock Band, I could just pay, like $1.99 or like $5 for packs, and I have it forever. Yeah. Forever.
They should have options for both, I think.
I think they will add it, like maybe a permanent option, maybe. But one thing I want to point out is on GHTV, the songs that you play for are on demand, but all the songs in the on demand catalog are being played in a shuffle order on GHTV channels, which shuffle the songs that you play for free.
Okay.
So that kind of sounds confusing. But
that is confusing. So what? So you don't have access to the same songs all the time, is what you're saying?
No, like the. Like I said, the on-demand songs are, like, on the channels.
Yep.
So, like, you can play the channels constantly on a shuffle for free. You just won't have the on-demand, like, play what song you want when you want. But, like, the songs and the catalog are there. They're just being shuffled.
Gotcha. All right. And I think that having the Guitar Hero TV thing allows them, if there's one positive thing about it, and literally I think there's probably one positive thing about it, they do have the ability to add songs like way quicker, I feel.
Night before last on the 20th, whenever the game came out, new songs were actually popping up as I was playing.
Yeah, that is the advantage of it. That is definitely an advantage.
Like, I would play one song, and then, like, whenever I would go back to the song catalog, like, there was, like, 5 more songs added.
Right.
And then, here's like, play another song, and there's more added.
I'm going to wait for somebody like me who gets pissed with this game and sells it at GameStop, and I'm going to wait till the used price goes down to, like, $20, and I'll pick it up.
Same. I'm going to grab it for the cheap, too, because I don't want to pay $100 for this. I'm sorry. If the guitars worked on both and I could just buy the game, I would think about it. But the new guitar, like, honestly, I'm not a guitar player, so I'm not a huge fan of the double rows, and I'm not a huge fan of the buttons being set into the fret. But I understand. I mean, Turtle can say more to this, but I understand that is way more realistic. And for people who do play guitar, it is easier or feels more natural, right?
Yeah, like, I play guitar, and, like, for me, it just, like, the 3-button, 2 rows, like, feels a lot more natural when, like, hitting chords and stuff like that.
Right. So, like, That's why. That's another thing. Another reason why I agree with clowns, and I'm just gonna have to wait because, I mean, if this is at Black Friday, this is 50. It's gonna tempt me because it's close to launch, and you know I do think the set list is better. I think the set list that comes on the disc is better.
I will just go ahead and say, like, as far as like playability, like Rock Band 4 is more accessible to anyone. Like right. Guitar Hero, the way it's set up is more for like they're trying to simulate playing a guitar, which is not.
And that's why I pawned my electric guitar and pawned my acoustic guitar and I pawned my amplifiers back in the day.
Man, I would have loved to get into guitar playing, but it just wasn't for me. I mean, I didn't try too hard, but.
I mean, drummers were always the coolest people in bands anyway.
Word. I agree. Where can you play drums? On Rock Band. Is it going to be singing what? Guitar Hero eventually or no?
Yeah, there's.
Oh, there's, I see that guitar.
They're singing Guitar Hero right now.
Yeah, that's what I figured. I mean, that's what I thought. Sorry. I see that guitar behind you. What kind of guitar is that?
Oh, that's not. That.
This is just a sticker?
Yeah, it's like a. That's actually a picture frame.
Gotcha. Oh, wow, that's interesting. See, Turtle lives the guitar life, so I do trust his opinion, his expert opinion on the guitars. It's just not for me. Like, I think I do agree with him that it probably is more natural, but it's just not for me. And I do, and you know, everyone know, if you know me, you know I love that clicking on that guitar. Am I right, Assassin? When you strum, I love that click. Love that.
Like yesterday, whenever I was in party chat on Xbox playing Guitar Hero, and I was like, sorry, I'll mute it. You were like, no, I like the sound.
Love it. Love it. Assassin, what do you think from what you've seen of both? Which one do you think is better?
I think they're both have their ups and downs. I want to get Guitar Hero, though.
I mean, I would love to get it too, but just not for 100. Sorry. Especially after I just dropped the money on the band bundle, whatever it is. How many guitars maximum can play in Guitar Hero?
I think it's like 3.
Is it 3?
From what I've heard.
Yeah.
Plus vocals.
Right. Okay. That's a lot of clicking in one room. Am I right, Assassin?
Yep. 3 too many.
Did you just imagine like...
You should do it in your room.
Yeah, Assassin, you should. You should stream it, connect microphone on with the clicking.
No.
I was watching him stream Rock Band 4 last night, and like, oh, I could hear the song, and like, the rest of the time was just like...
Wow. Yep. Well. All right, anything else to say about this more? I mean... If you're a Rockman fan, you're a Rockman fan. If you're a Guitar Hero fan, you're probably a Guitar Hero fan. Like, nothing... I don't think anything about these games is going to really change your mind. I think Guitar Hero, even though they've changed, like, the bands in the background... The band and the live action in the background, I think they've changed that, but it still feels very much like a Guitar Hero game. I don't know. Something about it. I can't put my finger on it, but it still does feel like Guitar Hero, and Rockman still feels like Rockman, so...
One cool thing that I do like is in GHTV, instead of the live band, you got the music videos for the song that you're playing in the background.
Oh, that's cool.
And, like, they are going to be working with iHeartRadio and recording live concerts for premium shows. Mm-hmm. And whenever people hear premium, they think, like, I have to pay for that to access it.
Right.
But the premium... In the game, I want to go ahead and make a quick mention is the premium shows can be accessed free, but there's requirements. Like, you have to get, like, for one of the premium shows, you can pay with Hero Cash, which is the microtransaction.
Yep.
Or you can get 3 stars on 3 different songs as a requirement to access it for free.
Hmm. Interesting. I like that. That's fine. I think that's okay. See, I think Guitar Hero is putting a lot more, like, interesting and more modern things into their game, which I do appreciate. Where Rock Band 4 is kind of like, Harmonix is kind of giving you the familiar old school thing that we all knew and loved, just on new generation and still pumping out, like, you know, DLC every week, still giving you that huge library of songs that you have access to. And Guitar Hero is trying to make the game more modern. I do appreciate that, but... I don't know. I'm still a Rock Band person. And I was a huge Guitar Hero person. Like, Guitar Hero 1 and 2, played the hell out of that. That Explorer controller is still my favorite. The Guitar Hero 2 Explorer, still my favorite controller of all time. But I don't know. Is the stream 2 hours now? No, we're pretty much done. Yeah, I figured this would only take 10 minutes, and it's taking 20 for the Guitar Hero. So we're pretty much done. Anything else to say about Guitar Hero versus Rock Band?
In December, you could probably port your Rock Band 3.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Rock Band 4. They announced.
Right.
And then that, aren't they pulling off the shelves on October 30th?
No, they're not pulling off the shelves.
They're pulling it off the marketplace, retailers will just
sell out their stock.
Yeah, they're just not going to get stock in.
Yeah, so if you want your Rock Band 3, you're going to have to buy it. If you want your Rock Band 3 songs in Rock Band 4, you're going to have to buy a Rock Band 3 copy if you don't have one.
One thing that really surprised me when they made the announcement is, if you remember importing Rock Band 1 and Rock Band 2 into Rock Band 3, there were certain songs you cannot import because of license.
Yep.
But they said all 83 songs from Rock Band 3 will be exportable.
That's awesome. I do like that. Which just shows that they're putting the effort in to get that library to be huge. And they do want the library to be, you know, stuff for everyone. And that's what makes Rock Band amazing. But
also, I have no way of confirming this since I'm on PlayStation. But I read online that the Green Day Rock Band export is starting to show up for some Xbox players.
I'm going to have to check that after the show.
So if you have Green Day Rock Band exported, then just go on the Xbox store and the songs should show up as free or purchased.
Yeah, I'll definitely check that after the show. But, yeah, that's awesome. That's good to hear. The only thing that's not exportable, I guess, is the Beatles one.
Yeah, Beatles is the only thing that is not will be exportable, but everything else can be exported.
That sucks. I wanted to play my Hey Jude. Am I right, Assassin?
Yeah, except I had Beatles Rock Band on the Wii.
Ew!
Yeah.
Yuck. It's like getting really Guitar Hero
Alive. Bottom of the barrel.
It's like getting Guitar Hero Alive on iOS.
Wow, well, Assassin.
I'm not going to say
question,
anything.
Why the Wii, Assassin? Why?
Because that's all I had at the time.
Ew!
Oh, wow. I got a quick and funny story for you. One Christmas, I wanted Guitar Hero World Tour for the Wii. But
ew.
This was because I didn't have a current-gen console. Like, I didn't have a PS3 or a 360. But I said, if I can't get a PS3, then I want a World Tour for the Wii. So I get a PS3 for Christmas and World Tour for the Wii.
Whoa, that sucks. That's funny. That is funny. And with that, we are done. Just over 1 hour and 10 minutes. Congratulations, people. Kappa Chippy, congratulations for winning your Tales of the Borderlands code. Tales from the Borderlands, I should say. I'll send that to you right after the show. We still have people coming in spamming. God damn. Anyway, so yeah, that's the end. Thank you for coming by and checking out the show. I thought it was a good one today. Good job, team. Check us out. If you aren't watching the video version, you're listening to the audio version, check us out at twitch.tv/4guyswithquarters every Thursday, 5 p.m. Eastern. If you can't watch us live but you want to watch the show, go to youtube.com/4guyswithquarters to find our archived episodes that are slowly but surely making their way to the YouTube channel. Find us on social networks. That's how you probably heard about our giveaway today. Assassin, good job with that. Thank you, sir. 4GwQPodcast is our Twitter, and Facebook is just facebook.com/4guyswithquarters. And check out our website, 4guyswithquarters.com, for news, reviews, articles, old episodes, moviepass.com, sign up, that ask kind of sass. Thing. Ask, hashtag ask sassy. I promise by next week we will have at least one question in Ask Sassy. I already have one thought up, and I just got to put it on there. So We got to do it over. We just got to do it over text or whatever, over like Skype message, so we have the response in text form with misspellings and improper grammar and all. So, Assassin, when you respond, you better make sure it's formatted properly before you hit that enter, or else it's going on there, autocorrect and all. Wow. So.
Wow.
Just like whenever, what's his name, from the Titanfall developers said, you said he comforted Titanfall 2.
That was autocorrect, okay? That wasn't me.
Well, hey, it doesn't matter, autocorrect, that's going on the response.
Well, like, the chill rock band 4-stream was pretty good too, I gotta say.
Yeah, a chill rock band 4-stream last night. That was a good one. You should do that again, Assassin.
No, that was a one-time thing.
No
Never
way.
Happening again.
Wow.
You're too chilly to do it again?
It was cold last night.
Wow. All right, well, that's it. Thank you, people. We'll see you next week. Peace.